Go to Create, Shaders, Unlit Shader, and call the resulting file whatever you want. Open it up in your favorite IDE, and let's get to business. Shaders in Unity are defined in Shaderlab. This is like the shader skeleton. You've got your encompassing shader definition with its name and category at the top. Then inside, you have your properties section. This defines the kind of things we can edit. Textures, colors, what have you. Underneath that, we have a list of subshaders. Every subshader you add will be used for a different circumstance, usually to be used on a different platform, like mobile or the Wii U, but also in case you want a specific shader for the editor. For now, we only need one. Then, inside the shader, we have a list of parsers, each one coded in HLSL or CG. These are like the shader's juicy innards. Each pass represents sending the data of the 3D model we're going to render to the GPU. I'd recommend only having one of these, unless you absolutely need another one. For each subshader, or each individual pass, you can define tags. These are like the shader's... text returns? Tags tell us to enable or disable certain features of the Unity's renderer at any one point. Find a list of possible tags on this page. This is a standard vertex and fragment shader in Unity, coded in CG by default, but you can use HLSL if you want. As of which, we have two functions, vert and frag, each of which with a corresponding struct that acts as their input. Find a list of possible inputs you can have on this page. Remember that all of our properties need to be defined as variables here before we use them in the functions. The first function, vert, is our vertex shader. Its current job is to process the vertices of the object as they're translated onto the screen. We can mess around with the vertices here by altering their properties. It also has some fake FOD for when the object is really far away. Once the vertices of each face have been translated to the screen, that face will be divided into individual pixels called fragments. We process these pixels in the frag shader, usually by finding their color by sampling a texture using their UV coordinate. But we can also multiply that texture color by our own property or set up a fake light direction in the properties and use some vector maths to make a simple diffuse lit shader. Finally, create a material and set it to your shader at the top there so you can actually apply it to your game object. Your material is like the shader's skin. Okay, just in case any potential employees are listening, I'm not an actual cannibal or anything. I just need a comedic through line so this tutorial isn't mind-numbingly boring. Unfortunately, Unity's lighting system is considerably more complicated than that of a simple dot product. Unity's way of abstracting this so we don't have to worry about it is to use surface shaders. Instead of separating out the processes of vertices and fragments, surface shaders uses a Frankenstein of both, allowing you to alter the properties of the object's surface, such as its base color, its normal, or its transparency, and then it will generate its own vertex and fragment shader to compile. It's a little restrictive in the things you can do, but it doesn't necessarily stop you from still using the vert and frag functionality, you just have to be a little careful with it. In terms of the actual code, CG and HLSL aren't too different, but make sure you're not mixing the two. If you're familiar with C#, then a simple way to explain it is that everything is a float now. You want an integer? It's a float. You want a boolean? It's a float. You want an n-dimensional vector? We got float 2s, float 3s, and float 4s. Why do we need a float 4? Because colors are now 4-dimensional float vectors with channels for red, green, blue, and alpha. Access the individual channels of the vectors using .uv, .xyzw, .rgba, or any combination of those sets of letters. You want matrices? Also floats. You want a string? They don't exist because they're lame. Some of these data types do still exist, but converting between each other is either impossible or inefficient. So, boom, everything is a float now. Oh, and instead of accessing individual pixels in a texture, you need to sample them. In case you need to do something special if the UV coordinates are, for example, outside the bounds of the texture or in between two different pixel values. In terms of the actual logic behind the code, shader programming uses a flow-based progression model, as the vert and frag shaders are being run through the GPU. That means no branching statements and no loops. You need to do all the necessary maths in a straight sequence of instructions, usually with all the mathematical functions you can find. The main function that's helpful is lerp, where you supply two values, a and b, and then a lerp factor that tends to range between 0 and 1. At 0, the function will return a, at 1, the function will return b, and at 0.5, it will return halfway between those two values. Also, since the GPU has many different cores that run the instructions for each vertex and pixel, they cannot communicate with each other, meaning that every series of instructions can only handle the information for the vertex or pixel it was given. It can be tricky to think like this and navigate it in the most efficient way. If you saw my stream last week, you'll know it requires a great deal of thought, maths, and horrible, horrible code. But once you get into the swing of things, it can be great fun and will help make your games look just that little extra flashy. I hope this tutorial has helped you come to grips with the complex world of shader programming. It's a lot more flexible and efficient than Shader Graph, but can often be difficult to comprehend. I'll link a bunch of really cool examples below. Plus, there are some awesome videos by Michael Jasper Ashworth, where he does really cool shader breakdowns for famous Nintendo games, so I'd recommend checking him out. Like and subscribe, and thanks for stopping by. Next time, we'll be creating a cool new Obra Dinn-esque shader, but if you'd like me to cover something else, put it down in the comments below. In fact, put whatever you want in the comments below. I really desperately need comments on videos for some reason. Maybe if I say really controversial opinions, it'll work. Unreal has a better shader graph than Unity. RPG Maker 2003 was the peak of game engines. I think long, slow-paced tutorials are a necessity to the community. I'm not interested in Godot, no matter how many videos the algorithm recommends me.